If we follow the money, where does it lead? Which states in the US have the most millionaires? Can you guess? You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're going to look at where rich Americans live. I'm going to get into some other factors after that. Let's begin by taking a look at America's millionaires by state. So this comes out of How Much, and this website likes to do very good graphics that are easy to show, and that's why I bring them to you as often as I can. This right here is showing us that California, in terms of total amount, has 885,000, all right? But if you look on a percentage basis, it's very different. So I'm going to show you a chart that is easier to look at in this case, top 10 states with the highest concentration of millionaires. So it is broken down by the two factors. Looking at it, you see that California is actually number 10 in this case. So that's 885,000 millionaires, but 6.61% of all households. Maryland is on the top of the list, followed by New Jersey, Connecticut, Hawaii, and Alaska. Now, looking at this, I have to also address, where is the money coming from? This is important to be able to understand the industries in these areas, understand the financial system, the way it works, different taxation plans that each state has. There are many factors here. And also, is this really a skewing of the numbers where a few select people are earning a large percentage of that money? We'll see. Look at this, the most profitable industry in all 50 US states. So you could see how it is all broken down. I'm not going to do every single one on here, you'll fall asleep, but you will see that different industries are dominant in different states, and that is important to look at because, for example, you may get more out of tech than you would out of farming or fishing, for example. One could be much more lucrative than the other, and you have more businesses operating in a different country, more major corporations, there's potential for more millionaires, right? A lot of millionaires actually work for these big institutions. These millionaires don't necessarily mean that they're wealthy by any means. They're probably in debt like everybody else. Now, looking at this here, Sotheby's, you can see that they did this wonderful auction for this vehicle. And what would you pay for this right here? What do you think? How much would you pay? I'll tell you, it's a Ferrari. Okay, so it's obviously worth a considerable amount. I'm just going to scroll down. I don't want to go too fast because the price is right here. It's a 1962 Ferrari. Okay, what do you think? Can you see that? How about if I show you here? Most expensive car ever sold at auction fetches $48 million. It's unbelievable what people are willing to pay for this. They're paying for the artwork and different collectibles. So there are individuals at the very top end of the spectrum that are making tons and tons of money, and you should definitely be paying attention to what's going on. I'm seeing the great divide in between the rich and the poor, and there's no way to put that otherwise. We have seen this escalating in recent years, particularly over the last few, where that stimulus and everything has sort of worn off during the post-financial crisis era, and now we're left with a few select people that are making more money than ever before, okay? So this is something that everybody is not really aware of because they do their 9-to-5 and they just go on about their day. Tiffany & Co. reported soaring profit and sales in the latest quarter, underscoring well-heeled shoppers' willingness to spend with luxury brands. So this is not the only luxury brand that's been doing very well recently. I would definitely say that people are more and more in debt than they ever have been, and this has allowed them to go out and finance these purchases of expensive vehicles and jewelry and, you know, all different kinds of apparel and all these things that people ultimately really don't need. Their liabilities, and they will unfortunately be burdening them in the near future. It's going to happen. It happened in 2008. It's going to happen again. And the more that people get themselves into debt, the worse it's going to be. Now, this can be for somebody who is, you know, earning $30,000 a year, or that could be for those millionaires. It doesn't mean that because they're a millionaire that necessarily that, you know, equates to anything. A lot of these people, they have very expensive cars, very expensive houses, expensive lifestyles, and they have to push it to the max. That's what they're doing, and it's not good at all. Okay, so that's all for this video. If you found it informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a thumbs up, it helps to support the channel. Do appreciate that very much. And if you want the financial education that was not taught to you in schools, these two books have it all. Check them out. Link is in the description below. And if you're more interested in the audiobook version, you can get that at themoneygps.com.